Hello guys, my name is Daniel, he's Dimitrios, and we're doing a review on Black Panther.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're a little late, a lot late, but whatever, let's do it. Oh, this is full with spoilers, but I'm sure you guys have seen the movie already.
Every single one of you, yeah.
Yeah, but let's just tell what we think. So yeah, what was the base plot of Black Panther?
So we have this city.
You forgot to mention that in the beginning, millions of years ago, a giant meteor exploded.
Magical meteor.
Magical meteor with vibranium exploded.
In Africa.
In Africa, in Wakanda.
Yeah.
And it's magic, it heals you, it gives you
superpowers
and stuff.
Fatal wounds, and this thing will heal you in a couple of hours. Yeah, it will bring you back to life.
Yeah, and all of the leaders of Wakanda,
yeah,
they fought and they choose one king who drinks the
And he's the only one who have the privilege to
becomes
a Black Panther. But if you think about it, with all those flowers, everyone of Wakanda can gain those powers.
There's not enough flowers, I think. It's only one room with flowers.
Yeah, but they can make more, right?
I don't know. Okay, anyway, Black Panther has got some problems because one guy, Andy Serkis, Gollum?
That was the name. Maybe.
No, the Gollum guy who was really funny with one arm with the exploding cannon.
The main bad guy?
That's not the main bad guy.
Second bad guy. But...
Yeah, also he stole some vibranium. And the main bad guy, Michael B. Jordan, Killmonger, he wants to be king.
Yeah.
Because
he
spoilers,
wants to be king, yeah.
He has ambition to a throne because
he has the royal blood.
Yeah, his uncle was the brother of Black Panther's father. So.
Yes. The moment.
Wakanda is really. It's like they don't want to share technology with anybody.
Yeah.
Nobody knows that Wakanda has this amazing
technology.
They're hidden from the world.
They don't want to hide this technology because they don't want to share it. They're afraid what other people will do with this.
Yeah, and so basically Michael B. Jordan wants to get revenge and spread all the technology.
But not just spread the technology, start a riot.
Yeah, but if you think about it, he's kind of right.
Yes, he's right. That's the best thing about the movie. The bad guys... They're bad, but they're right. They have...
I don't think Gollum was right.
Yes, but
he was
awesome.
Was fun, yeah.
Oh my god, he was so awesome. The moment...
I was sad when he died.
Yes, the movie
could,
got a lot...
They could have used him more.
Yeah.
I think.
A lot more. He was so funny, man. He was so funny. Something else, the part in the casino, when he was there.
Oh, yeah, but I don't know, that scene was kind of strange for me.
Why is this strange? Remember when, how T'Challa, he went in this the thing that was scanning him for weapons?
Black Cougar guy, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, and they're scanning them for weapons when they come into the weird casino in South Korea. And they go there to catch this guy, Gollum.
Yeah.
From Lord of the Rings, they want to catch Gollum. And they come in and there is a metal detector and... They don't wear weapons, and then Gollum comes in with his
and every single one of these guys. Beep, 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 yeah.
Yeah, it's funny.
The scene when were...
You forgot in the beginning there's a scene in the past when... With the bad guy's father Killmonger and Forrest Whitaker, I forgot his... Do you remember the guy with the stick?
Yes, I
don't
remember.
Do fight.
Yes, yes.
The guy from Star Wars also.
Yeah.
What do you do? And the guy from... What else? He's the guy with the stick.
The guy who's in charge in all ceremonies.
Yeah. And he's tearing the ghetto or something in Oakland.
Maybe, yeah.
Or some city. Yeah, and T'Challa, our Black Panther.
Yeah.
Now, in the present, his father is Black Panther and he goes there and turns out that Killmonger's father betrayed Wakanda.
He was sharing technology and stuff.
Yeah, he was he was giving them weapons to do something, you know, what.
And he kills him.
Yep, he kills him because he tries to kill Forrest Whitaker.
Yes.
He tries to kill him and then he...
And then he left his...
But if you think that's really good build-up and backstory to the villain, because they show it, we don't know that it's him. He's the little boy who's playing outside.
Yeah.
And then we see the scene again when they make the ritual thing with the vibranium plant and covering with the sand. And he remembers it, and that's the thing I liked a lot about this movie. The villain is really good. Michael B. Jordan is really awesome. He has amazing backstory. He has some clear motivation.
Yeah.
He's not just, oh, I'm evil. I want the exploding weapon to destroy everything.
Yeah, and he's really cool.
Yeah.
The guy was awesome. Damn.
Yeah, I like how he talked. Everybody in this movie talks with an African accent because, you know, they're in Wakanda.
Yeah, except him.
Except him, he says things like, nah.
Nah.
And stuff like
you're sitting there comfortably in this chair.
Yeah. And I liked that. It was fun for me.
Yeah, it was so awesome. Wait.
Oh, we forgot to say that this movie is getting great reviews. Really awesome reviews. And I think it's an awesome movie.
The movie is really awesome, but
it has its problems, I think.
Like any other movie. But I got really high expectation for this movie. I was waiting for him to come home to go watch it.
Yeah.
He said don't watch it without me. I was like, okay.
Really high expectation.
Yeah.
And we saw it, and it was good.
It was really nice.
It kind of got slow for me. In the middle. After the casino scene, there is a car chasing scene.
Car chasing scene, but there was a cool part there. The one of the chicks.
With the
spear. Yeah, the way he throws it.
Yeah,
the look on her face.
The African, general.
Yes.
I forgot her name, who doesn't want to wear a wig. She destroys a car with a spear.
Yeah,
cool.
Just like that. And they have a car.
But that's the only memorable thing from that car chasing scene, I think. It was too long for me.
Yeah, we get to saw how the suit of T'Challa absorbing bullets and explosions.
The Black Panther suit.
He destroyed the whole car.
Oh, I forgot to tell his sister, she makes all this cool technology thing and to do all this stuff. And she basically tells him that his suit absorbs the kinetic vibration from punches and stuff.
I
and
really
then
like that.
I like that, but I didn't like the suit. I think it looked better
in the last one.
In Avengers, or what movie was he in? He was in Captain America Civil War.
Captain America Civil War, yeah.
His suit there is way more cool. It's all black and it's a real...
It's bigger.
Yeah.
The sister was the only one who didn't like all those old rituals.
Yeah,
stuff.
Because Wakanda... That's one strange thing. They have all this amazing technology, but at the same time they follow some really stupid... Rituals and traditions.
Yes.
They follow some stupid traditions.
Some of the traditions were really awesome, but the other ones not so much.
Yeah, like they have this whole fight scene with when he becomes king and they're like, who challenges the king?
Yes.
And the guys come in the mountain.
Oh my god, this guy.
What is the name of the tribe who separated? There are five tribes and one tribe separated.
Umbaku.
Yeah, that was the name of the Jabari, the trap of Jabari.
The trap of Jabari, that guy, he was so awesome.
Yeah, and he fights M'Baku, and basically, if M'Baku wins that fight, he becomes king,
yeah.
But that's, why not have an election?
This, is way more advanced than anything else in the world.
Way more advanced country, and who beats up the other guy, he's king.
That doesn't make sense,
If he has royal blood,
That
doesn't make sense. And his sister is like, oh, this is stupid, remember?
Yeah, she was the only one there.
He was the only one who didn't like
straight,
the tradition. But that scene when he fights M'Baku, who challenged him for the throne, is to set up, they're gonna have a fight with Michael B. Jordan later. So, It makes sense.
Yeah, it makes sense. But Michael B. Jordan is way more buff than
Yeah, he's ripped.
he's way more, yeah. Something else, there was a moment when Umbaku said he threatened the FBI guy that he's going
Oh,
to
I
eat
forgot
him.
to tell about the FBI guy. So
Okay.
a little guy comes with them to Wakanda to get
Who,
healed.
to get healed because he gets shot in the back, protecting
Yeah.
one of his generals, and he thinks that T'Challa is straight with him when he
Yeah.
told him he didn't have so much vibranium, and
Yeah,
then he
but
realized the whole city
yeah,
that.
because they think that Golem stole all the vibranium,
Yeah,
but
but
nah.
he didn't even scratch the surface. The whole
Yeah.
city is under the city there is a rock that is made from
Yeah.
vibranium. Yeah. And
But
yeah.
the FBI guy, I think, do you know what we? I said to you this after a movie when we got out that they shouldn't have killed the Golem guy, Andy
Yeah.
Serkis. I think that he
He
should
was some.
become the good guy.
Yeah.
The FBI guy was he didn't do much.
Yeah.
He did explode some ships in the end, but
That was okay.
yeah. But why have him? He.
But he was a retired pilot, one of the best
Yeah,
pilots.
but
Yeah.
it would be better to have Golem become good. Be
Yeah.
oh, I'm sorry about or something.
Yeah. Because
I
he's.
don't know. I just think so because he was a cool character and
Yeah,
funny.
really cool character. Yeah.
So yeah. Anyway,
So.
Killmonger kills Golem. That's his way to get into Wakanda.
Yeah, of course. He's
Yeah,
like.
he. Yeah, they have a tattoo here, and he brings Golem to the guy who. What was the guy name? The tribe who guard the borders. Do you remember?
Oh, the guy
The.
that so easily betrayed his wife and his king.
Yeah.
No, I didn't like that.
The actor from Get Out, if you watch the movie.
Yeah, I watched the movie.
Yeah. The main actor from Get Out, I forgot his name. So he goes to him and he wants revenge for Andy Serkis because he killed his
His parents,
parents, I
his
think.
parents, yeah.
Yeah, way back. Oh, that's why they can't have Andy Serkis be the good guy because that guy hates him.
Yeah.
Yeah, and Killmonger, Michael B. Jordan bring his body and I bring a gift and they put him in front of Black Panther in
Yeah.
the royal room.
Ask my name. Oh, when he got in
Oh,
the room.
yeah, by the way, that room really reminded me of Phantom Menace
Hey, you right.
when they're sitting and
All the
Padme
chairs
Amidala and
and
telling the
Michael B.
conference.
sits there in the middle where he's like
Yeah.
Anakin and everyone, take a seat.
Yeah, and he goes there and basically Black Panther says, "Tell me one reason I should not kill you," something like that.
Yeah, and he's like,
And
ask who I am, and the guy's like, I know who you are. And the guy with the fucking lip, with the hooked up lips, the thing that he has,
oh
yeah.
yeah, there's some tribe with fucking plates in their
I
mouth.
will I will pay money to see a guy like that eat a soup.
Yeah,
I wanna
it
see it.
will be fun.
Yeah.
I forgot Killmonger's Wakandan name.
What can.
What was his name? I have no idea. So yeah, anyway, he goes there and he's like, "What? Tell my name." And he has royal blood and he wants to challenge him for the throne.
Yeah. He challenged, you
And
know?
he challenged him for
And
the
he
throne
kicked
and
his
they
ass.
have a fight, like in the beginning
Yeah.
with M'Baku.
M'Baku. But this time.
But this time Michael B. Jordan kicks his ass
Yeah, and he
really
kills
bad.
the guy.
Yeah, and he kills Forrest Whitaker and he throws him off the cliff
Yeah,
because
they.
they fight in a cliff and there's a waterfall
Yeah.
and the other tribe members like they're like there with like a wall for
Yeah,
them not to escape.
and they're shorting the distance.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But the second fight scene like that, I liked it. I liked the second one.
Yeah.
Michael B. Jordan kicks his ass and but again, that's a really stupid rule. He beats him and he's now king and
And
he's
then,
this
yeah.
crazy guy and he's doing all this crazy stuff and they have to follow him.
I didn't like that.
And
I didn't like it.
his most loyal general
Suddenly betray him because
no,
he.
she doesn't betray him, he's loyal to the
No,
throne.
oh yeah. I mean her husband.
Yeah.
He was He was ready. I mean, he was like, oh, the king's dead.
I'm with Michael B. Jordan now. And so basically his plan is to spread all the weapons and technology.
But not just spread all the weapons.
Yeah, he wants to have an uprising and everything.
And blow shit up.
Yeah, and out that Black Panther is alive. He threw him
off
the waterfall, but he's still alive.
He was retrieved by M'Baku.
Michael B. Jordan, when he drinks the magical flower,
he
he's like,
everything.
Burn all the flowers. I'm king.
And
they burn the flowers. But they save one.
Yeah, his sister saved one.
His sister or his love interest?
Maybe his love interest.
I forgot her name.
Doesn't matter.
She was Maskanada from Star Wars, I remember that. Yeah, so they save one plant and they go Theron, his mother. What were they calling her? Queen Mother or something?
Queen Mother.
Or something like that. His mother, his love interest, and the FBI guy escaped and they run to the to the other tribe, Jabari.
They want to give the
Terra in the mountains. And they go there, they want to give M'Baku the flower.
The flower to challenge.
To challenge Michael B. Jordan.
And
but
his ass.
M'Baku is like, no.
Come with me.
Your king is still alive, and he shows them.
And they bury him in the snow.
Yeah, and they bury him in the snow, give him the flower, and he resurrects.
Yeah.
But before that, he's like talking shit to his father because he killed his uncle. Basically, he killed his brother.
Yeah.
And yeah.
This way, he repays his debt, and that's it. But he refused to help him return the throne.
Yeah. He refuses, but he comes back in the
end. Yeah, comes back. And he comes with an epic line. It's time to witness the might of...
We have to set that up. Don't
okay,
say it
okay,
yet.
Okay, okay.
So, and Black Panther is alive again, and he goes to fight. They go to confront Michael B. Jordan, who is already sending weapons and stuff. And his friend, who is in the border, the Get Out guy from Get Out, he's changed completely his mind.
Yeah.
In the beginning he's like, no, don't open the border, don't do this.
And now magically.
And now, come on, shoot everybody.
Shoot everybody.
Give them the weapons. And yeah, and that's one thing, do you see how quickly they have a fight? I mean, he comes back and he's like, I'm not dead, the challenge isn't over. And that's smart, because in the beginning when they set up the challenge, they say this challenge can only end with surrender or death.
Yeah.
So he didn't surrender, he didn't die, he was just thrown out from this.
Yeah, and the challenge can continue.
Yeah, he's like,
no,
the challenge isn't over. But Michael B. Jordan says, nah, I'm done with that. And they try to kill him. But why? Why didn't they follow tradition? He's still king.
Yeah, but he's...
Kinda,
yeah. And all of
it was really strange how they turned to fight.
Yeah, and he's on the ground, everybody...
it was strange.
They were stabbing him, yeah.
Yeah, I don't know, it happened too fast.
Too fast, yeah.
That fight.
Let's talk about the fight between the two guys. Michael B. and T'Challa.
We talked about it?
No, the last fight.
Oh, before that, M'Baku, he's one of my favorites. he says, I'm not gonna help you, but he comes to help him in the end. And there's one of my favorite scenes, that little guy from Get Out, who is the border tribe something, he's standing there, and they come, the Jabari tribe, and M'Baku guy, the leader of the Jabari, catches him by the head and he pulls him up and says, now witness the full might of the Jabari. Now witness the might of the Jabari, and grabs him first hand. That's really funny.
That was awesome.
Yeah, and Michael B. Jordan wants to kill what was the name of T'Challa's sister? Zuri. Yeah. He wants to kill Zuri, and Black Panther sees that and he confronts him and they have a fight.
Under the city,
they transport the vibranium with some kind of trains.
And those trains, when they're active, they can influence the armor.
Yeah, they stopped the armor
Yeah, they
or
stopped
something
it.
like that.
No, not just stopping, but you can see
They,
there is some cuts in.
yeah, they stopped the powers of Vibranium for a little.
For a little,
That's
yeah.
what they say. Because it's too volatile and it can explode.
Yeah.
And that's why. Yeah, and they have a fight there, and that fight was kinda. I didn't like that pretty much.
Kind of cheap.
Yeah, the visual effects didn't look good to me. It looked like. Do you remember there was one scene in Blade? When they fight and he puts the guy's head in the train, it looked like that. It looked strange. The effects didn't look too good. Particularly there. Yeah, the effects were okay. They're not amazing, they were okay, but that fight they had, the last fight, I think it was. Why did they fight there? Fight in the top. Why fight in this strange CGI stuff? Oh, okay,
The more
for the suits to have to.
the suit needs to have an opening so one of them can
Yeah,
hit the other.
but I didn't like the damn fight, by the way.
The fight could be more badass, but
Yeah, in the end, T'Challa kills Killmonger.
yeah, with an awesome move, by the way, the move,
Yeah, and he's like, oh,
awesome.
that move was good.
Even he was impressed.
Yeah,
And
the last scene was really cool.
when they
When
were
Killmonger dies. And he's like,
I want to see the best, the best place.
no. His father told him that they set it up in the beginning scene when he's little. His father is telling him that the sun set or sunrise, one of, I don't remember, was it the sunset? I
It
think it
was
was the sunset.
sunset, yeah.
He told him that the sunset in Wakanda is the most beautiful in
Yeah.
the world. And so Black Panther brings him up to see
The sunset.
the sunset
And he
thing.
said, we can save you. And the guy was like, oh no, better dead than to
No,
be.
he says, what, to chain me up? And he says,
Something about his ancestors.
no, he says, I want to be buried in the ocean with my ancestors who chose to die
Then be.
free than rather be
Yeah, and he pulled out the
prisoners.
blade of his chest and died. And I was really sad because that was he was awesome.
Yeah, he's the best villain from all
The
the
best
Marvel
villain,
movies,
yeah. He was the
I
best
think.
villain.
Because if you look back, Thor Ragnarok, I really like that movie. The villain was his own sister, and he's like, I'm gonna kill all of you. And then in Guardians of the Galaxy 1, the bad guy is a space warrior.
Space for, yeah.
He's a warrior, a space warrior. Ronan the Accuser, he has a. You forgot about him. He has a hammer. Okay, Thor 2, I don't remember even the bad guy, some elf guy.
Dark Elves.
But what was the name of the main bad guy?
Oh, have no idea.
So yeah, Marvel has a problem with villains. I think this is the best villain. He has a clear motivation. He doesn't want to explode the sky with the exploding machine.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's it. I mean.
Yeah. I really wish they showed more from Wakanda. We only
You only
see
see one street.
one street, like a set, and the other thing. Oh, we see the laboratory too of his sister.
That's not the city. That's underground.
Yeah, but it's still in Wakanda,
Yeah.
and they show, and the other things they show, it's all CGI, like wide shots
The
CGI.
only thing when they showed this street in Wakanda, the only advanced thing I saw was the train that was
No,
traveling here.
there's
What, the
really
buildings?
tall buildings and stuff.
Wow, we don't have tall buildings now.
No, they have a lot of futuristic looking stuff in there, but
Yeah,
we
okay,
didn't see
maybe.
it. We just see a white shot of it.
Yeah.
Um,
Man, we're gonna see a lot. We're gonna see more warriors of Wakanda in the upcoming Avengers.
probably.
We saw in the trailer how they're all running against some monsters and stuff.
The mid-credit scene, I remember the credit scene. They show Winter Soldier,
Yeah,
Bucky.
he was there and he was saved. He was brought back to life by T'Challa's sister.
Yeah. So, in the end, would you recommend this movie? Do you like it?
I like the movie. Go watch it, but
Yeah, for
don't
me,
go.
the movie was pretty fun. I liked it. I'm kind of getting tired of the Marvel movies, but I like Thor Ragnarok. I like this one too a lot.
He loves
So,
it.
yeah, it was pretty good.
Yeah.
I'm not so sure that this is the best
It's
Marvel
not the
movie.
best Marvel movie.
I'm not so sure about that. It's different. It's refreshing, and yeah, it's definitely a good Marvel movie, a real good one. It's not like Ant-Man that I didn't like. It's not like Thor 1 that's bad,
Okay.
or Captain America 1. Captain America 1 was really bad, if you
I
remember.
remember.
The second Captain America, amazing. First one, eh.
Not so much.
So yeah, it's definitely one of the best. I'm not gonna say
One
the
of the best,
best.
but not the best.
Maybe for some, I don't know. I liked it a lot. Go watch.
Go watch
You already have, but watch it.
it.